If string length and frequency are inverse to one another, as the string length gets shorter, the frequency will increase. For the proportion in the upper right, n is a fraction of the starting string length. Here, anything from 1 to 1/3. It's easier to visualize. That comes next. Without frets, it would be continuous, like this. The frets create a sequence of musical half steps. These are the semitone intervals for 12-tone equal temperament. For the fractional exponents here, the numerator is the number of the fret. I'm approximating high E at 330 cycles per second here. A compromised tuning results in an enharmonic fretboard where the sharps and flats are the same frequency. For each string, each fret raises the pitch by the semitone ratio, approximated here as 1.06 in decimal form. Everything is approximated to keep the visual imagery simple. Adjacent strings are a perfect fourth apart, a ratio of 4 to 3, or about 1.33, except for the second and third strings, which are a major third apart. The ideal ratio is 5 to 4, and they're only roughly approximated at about 1.26 here. The same frequency is found on different strings, 5 frets apart, a bit of a stretch. The second string is only a major third above the third string, so everything moves over a half step, and then the first string resumes the original pattern. Taking a closer look at how these frequencies are derived, the semitone ratio is the 12th root of 2, written here as 2 to the 1/12. And each fret raises the pitch by the same ratio, 2 to the 1/12, 2 to the 2/12, and so on. The number of the fret is the number of times the operation is repeated. In decimal form, the semitone ratio is 1.06. It's multiplied times the open string frequency, resulting in a frequency of about 87 cycles per second for the first fret, the F note. Moving over to the 7th fret, the ratio is 2 to the 7/12, about 1.498. It approximates 1.5 or 3/2 the perfect fifth. Multiplied by the open string frequency, and you get 123 cycles per second for the perfect fifth above the open string. And next, the inverse determines the fret position and the vibrating string length. 1 over 2 to the 1/12 equals approximately 0.944. Multiplied by an open string length of 650 millimeters, the vibrating length becomes 614 millimeters for the first fret. For the 7th fret, the result is 2/3 of the open string length. Now, starting with A equals 440, I'll see if I can demonstrate some of the difference from perfect or just tuning. Here is where the octaves are located. To get a just perfect fourth, you would need to move the 5th fret a little bit to the right to get a 1/4 string length. For a perfect fifth, the 7th fret needs to be slightly closer to the bridge. The low E string would be tuned to 110 times 3/4 equals 82.5. 440 times 3/4 would make the high E string 330 cycles per second. 220 times 2/3 will give you the open D string at 147. Open G is derived from the open D. 147 times 4/3 equals 196. B string is a major third above that. 196 times 5/4 equals 245. And now, 245 times 4/3 only equals 326.7. The numbers in one direction will not add up to numbers in the other direction. If you're interested, you can search for microtonal and just guitars to see what kind of solutions they've come up with. This is one of only two Creative Commons images I've found. You can see how many calculations were done. I once did some of the calculations. You can see a triad developing out of the harmonic series. And here is the heart of the problem. No multiple of the perfect fifth will ever equal any multiple of the octave. I'll go into more detail in another video.